this month's production of Fan Fiction Theater. I am your writer, host, director, narrator, and occasional actor, Megan. And this month's theme is Harry Potter. Before we move on, I'm going to allow our stage manager to introduce herself. Allison. You're excited to be working with me, and you're a huge fan of Harry Potter.
I'm excited to be working with you, and I'm a huge fan of Harry Potter.
Better. Now, fanfiction theater works when the actual characters come and perform fanfiction scenes, written by yours truly. I know that you just want me to get on to the good part and introduce our cast, right?
Yeah.
So the witches and wizards who really need no introduction, the cast of this month's Fan Fiction Theater.
My name is Harry Potter. I'll be playing the role of Harry Potter.
Hello, my name is Ginny Weasley, and I will be playing the role of Luna Lovegood.
But that's not what she says I'm playing. Do they update the scripts? Does this mean we all get new parts? I've always wanted to play a boy. I imagine it would be very interesting.
If we're making new parts, then I specifically request a part that is not in this show. I can think of a rather long list of things that would be much better than wasting my day with a bunch of Potter-loving fangirls.
That'd be fine with me. Nobody wants to hear anyway, Malfoy.
Don't be rude, Ron. We all agree to this. Hermione's right. My name is Ginny Weasley, and I'll be playing Ginny Weasley. I'm Hermione Granger, and I'll be playing Hermione Granger.
This is silly, right? We're all just playing ourselves. I'm Ron Weasley, and I'm Ron Weasley.
I'm Neville Longbottom, and I'll be playing myself.
I'm Luna Lovegood, and I suppose I'll be playing Luna Lovegood, though it would have been fascinating to play somebody else.
I'm Draco Malfoy, and I'll be playing the best-looking person in this cast. Yeah.
Charming seeker who won Hermione's heart. Just keep going. going.
Neville, stop. We're not here to talk about my love life.
Well, it might just happen anyway. Look who's back from practice.
Harry enters the common room, hair still damp from the shower he took after practice. hair still damp, Allison. He strides confidently across the room to where the trio is seated.
What's with the serious faces?
Neville has to find a date to the Yule Ball. All the champions have to walk in together and lead a dance.
That reminds me. Hermione Granger, would you be my date to the Yule Ball?
It's about time you asked. I was about to get worried.
Is that yes?
Yes, it's a yes.
Good, because Dad got me some really nice robes, and I already got you this necklace. I'm not sure it would look as pretty on anyone else.
Harry, it's beautiful. You're too sweet.
I am, aren't I? Now, let's see about getting Neville a date.
Wait, you're not following the stage directions.
Of course I am. Harry gives Hermione a kiss and then sits down.
Sits down between her and Ron and a kiss, not a peck on the cheek. Reset from Hermione's line. Try again.
Harry, it's beautiful. You're too sweet.
I am, aren't I? Now, let's see about getting Neville a date.
I don't see why Harry has to sit between Hermione and I. What does it matter where he sits?
Because he's dating Hermione and you are not. Can we continue?
I have no idea who I should ask.
What about Ginny?
Harry's right. Everyone knows she's had a thing for you, especially after you saved her life.
No, Ginny is my sister. You can't take her to the Yule Ball.
I don't see why not. She seems nice. The worst she can do is turn you down. Then we'll find you another date. You're the chosen one that has to be good for something.
You know I hate being called that. But you might have a point. I'll ask her.
That's the spirit. Now if you'll excuse us, I need some help with my potions essay.
Unable to find Ginny in the common room, Neville heads out into the halls. But it's not Ginny he finds as his feet carry him across the castle.
Neville Longbottom? What are you doing wandering the halls? Are you training for the next task?
No. Well, maybe a little. You're Ginny's friend, aren't you?
Did she say that? Oh, how sweet of her. My name is Luna. How are you training a little for the next task?
Well, it's not really a task. I have to find a date to the Yule Ball.
Well, have you asked anyone yet?
It's not that simple. It's not like you can walk up to a girl in the hall and say, would you like to go to the Yule Ball with me?
I would love to. It's so sweet of you to ask.
What?
I didn't expect you to ask me, but it's simply wonderful.
Wait, Luna.
Neville Longbottom asked me to the Yule Ball, and I find that I'm quite excited. Oh, but you wanted to say something?
Just that I'm excited as well.
That is sweet. It's getting close to curfew, so you better get back to the Gryffindor common room. See you tomorrow.
Neville stood in the hall for a long moment. He didn't know how he ended up on a date with Luna Lovegood, but part of him couldn't help but think it was fate. The end. Thank you, actors. Thank you. That was a wonderful performance. If we could all just follow the script as written, those stage directions that worked really hard on them.
Yeah, Harry, follow stage directions. I know you just better than that.
It was quite fun to imagine that you asked me to the Yule Ball. We did it so sweetly.
Personally, I didn't see much difference. Potter was arrogant, Longbottom stumbled all over himself, and Weasel was completely incapable of finding a date.
That just seems like reality.
one mate. It's not like that at all. Hermione's like my sister.
Don't bother, Harry. There's no use trying to talk to him when he's like this, trust me.
We're all set for the next scene.
Perfect. If our actors could just take their seats. Ahem. Their seats. We'll get started. Our second fanfiction is entitled Twilight Twins, and it stars Harry, Hermione, and some very special guests. From last month's quite popular Twilight episode, we have Bella and Edward Cullen and Jacob Black. Oh, and there's one more surprise. This fic has an original character, Becca Swan, and she will be played by me. Oh, thank you, thank you. No need for applause. Okay, well, maybe a little more. Thank you. If our actors could take their scripts and come on stage. This story takes place just after the fight at the Ministry of Magic. Harry has just realized he has a twin sister and has gone to Forks, Washington to find her because he needs her help to defeat the Dark Lord. He approaches the door and knocks.
Just a minute. Hello. What can I do for you?
Hi. I'm looking for Miss Swan.
Well, you found her. I'm Bella. Do you have a name to go with that attractive British accent?
What? Oh, yes. My name is Harry. Harry Potter.
Well, it's nice to meet you, Harry, Harry Potter. Would you like to sit down?
Yes, thank you.
So, what brings you here looking for me?
Well, you see, it's actually rather complicated. You see, I'm sort of a, well, maybe I should show you.
Who's at the door, Bella?
Oh, a British boy named Harry Potter.
A British boy, yummy accent and everything? Why, hello.
Who are you?
No, that was wrong. You need to act entranced by me. It's like, who are you? Try again.
Who are you?
Oh, well, you can take direction. Good to know. I'm Becca. It's a pleasure to meet you, Harry. What brings you to our door?
Beautiful women, it would seem.
Oh, you tell me more about that.
See? I told you I spelled something different. Are you two okay? Is this guy bothering you?
I wasn't bothering them. I was simply having a conversation with a beautiful woman.
Are you teasing the poor boy, Becca? You know how rude it is to string him along. You are my girl, after all.
Don't you mean she's our girl?
Jacob's right. I don't like it when you get possessive. Becca's our girl.
Down, you guys. There's plenty for me to go around. I can never just pick one of you. I love all of you.
And we love you. But, okay, what's going on with this stranger?
My name is Harry Potter, and I came here looking for Bella. Well, you might find this hard to believe, but I'm a wizard.
Figures. Can't meet a normal person in Forks.
What?
Jacob just means that I'm a vampire, he's a werewolf. A wizard, eh, just another in a long line of supernatural beings who spend time in Forks.
I see. Well, it turns out you've been living with one for some time. You see, back where I'm from, a very powerful dark wizard is killing people. According to a prophecy, I'm supposed to use a power he knows not in order to defeat him. I came here because that power supposed to be an incredibly powerful witch.
And you think it's one of us?
I think it's you, Bella. And there's more to it than that. You're my twin sister.
Wait, that doesn't make any sense. How can I be your sister? I'm not a witch.
You might not even know it. I didn't know it for a long time. But you have a very powerful magic within you.
I always knew Bella was special. Almost as special as Becca.
Except No one could be as special as Becca. I'm surprised you're not the witch.
Well, I, for one, am glad Becca isn't my sister, because it would be weird of me to do this.
Harry, stop! Don't kiss her!
What is it?
I found the adoption records. Your sister's name is Becca Swan.
Becca Swan is my sister?
Yes, and we need to get back with her right away. Is this her?
Yes. I'm Becca. And you are?
Hermione Granger. I could see you got all the good looks in the Potter family.
You are too sweet. But I suppose if I'm supposed to save the wizarding world, we should get going.
But before we go...
Hermione, what are you doing?
What? She's not my sister.
Allison. Allison. What? Can you read the narration? Finish the scene.
Becca left with Harry, and together they saved the entire wizarding world. The end.
Yay!
Do not remind me.
But our drama is long behind us now. We're happily married, and Jacob imprinted on Renesmee. Imprinted? What does that mean?
It's really nothing special. Come over here, and I'll explain what I can.
I would also be interested in learning how you transform without holding. I can write a wonderful article for the Twiddler.
You really need to get over yourself, Ron, or you're going to make Hermione mad.
We're all set for the next scene.
Wonderful. You heard the stage manager. Everyone to their seats. Thank you. Our third fanfic is entitled The Sextet, and it stars Harry, Ginny, Ron, Hermione, Neville, and Luna. If the actors could take your scripts. This fanfic takes place a year after Voldemort's defeat. The group is going to hang out at the Room of Requirement. After pacing the hall to open the door, they find a room that only contains bottles of fire whiskey and a bed.
What's going on in here? I wanted to relax, not take a nap.
I think the room has a different form of stress relief in mind. Fire whiskey?
What do you mean a different form of stress relief?
Well, I, for one, wouldn't object to a nice long nap. Ugh. That's a pretty comfy bed.
I think the boys still don't understand. They can be pretty thick sometimes.
What are you two on about?
Perhaps a demonstration is in order. Hermione.
What are you doing?
That one isn't in my script. Did I get the wrong one?
No, Luna, you're fine. We're just following the script. It's just a bit of stage kissing, Ron.
If we could all focus, we have show to do here. Reset to the kiss.
Oh, has the kissing started? Luna kisses everyone.
Oh, Luna, you don't read stage directions, you just do them.
Oh, sorry.
Luna, wait, no.
What is it? Did I do it wrong?
No, Luna, you're fine.
You're more than fine.
Ron, what's the problem?
I can't do this. Did you guys read the rest of the script?
Come on, Ron, it's not that bad.
I'm not doing it.
So this is what that famed Gryffindor courage looks like. Strumming off stage halfway through a scene. Don't feel bad, Basil. Not everyone can perform under pressure.
Shut up, you ferret.
What did you say?
I said, shut your mouth. What are you gonna do? Call your father on me? Oh, wait.
I watch yourself, Weasel.
Gentlemen, please, wands away. We have a show to do. We'll just move on.
That is disappointing. I was rather enjoying that scene.
Me too. You did a good job, Luna.
You really think so?
Yeah. I don't understand you, Ron. You finally get a scene for your wife, Miss Hermione. Quit.
so hard on Hermione. She's trying to do her best, like she always does.
Harry's right. We have to remember that what happens on stage is pretend. It's just a show. This is real.
Oh, is this another kissing scene? I like those.
Never heard of him. Who's Sirius Black?
He's my dad's best friend. My godfather.
It's okay, Harry. Let's just do the scene.
Okay. And Neville, you'll be Remus Lupin. No.
Wait. Aren't you forgetting somebody? I lived with a marauder for like 12 years.
You're right. Ron, since he was your rat, you can be Peter Pettigrew.
Awesome. All right. Peter's not in the scene.
Exactly. Sit down. Our characters are in the shrieking shack. They have just finished telling Lily about their monthly transformations.
Where did Peter go? I don't want to accidentally step on him.
Probably ran off. He's been doing that a lot lately. James reckons he's got himself another set of mates.
Does this mean you're not mad?
Mad? Why would I be mad?
Because I've been keeping this a secret from you.
A secret you kept to protect Remus. You had to know I could be trusted. You're a better man than I thought, James Potter.
A better man than she thought. You sure have Evans fooled.
Lay off, Black.
Or what? What's a better man gonna do about it?
Rake the Sebra! That's the tickling charm. Laugh.
Are you okay, Remus? I might not have been born in the wizarding world, but I know people think about werewolves.
But not you?
You're my friend, Remus. I may not have been born in the wizarding world, but oh no. Yeah, I know what people think about werewolves.
Wait, that guy's a werewolf? Why didn't I get to play that character?
Because you make a much better reckless dog animagus than a shy werewolf.
What's an animagus?
My godfather can turn into a big black dog.
Cool. If we continue from Lily's line.
Right, I know people think about werewolves.
But not you.
Well, you're my friend, Remus. You didn't stop being friends with me just because I'm a muggleborn.
That's not exactly the same thing.
Tell that to the Slytherins.
Are you two done with your heartfelt moment? I can use some help.
James, leave Sirius alone. He's turning a rather unattractive shade of purple.
Ruin all the fun.
I am never unattractive. But thanks for the save, Evans. I needed to catch my breath for this.
I could swear I watched them transform back into humans.
You'll get used to the fact that they're more mature as a stag and a dog than they ever were as people.
All right, I can see it. You trying to steal my girl, Remus?
What? No.
We did not come up here to watch you and Evan snog.
Jealous, Black?
Never. I just wish I'd invited a girlfriend up here, too.
Let's all just remind the werewolf how single he is.
Sorry, Remus. Lily and I are going to Hogsmeade. I'll see you back at the castle.
That's it? Hey, Evans. We all turn into animals, and Remus is a werewolf. You cool with that? Great. Let's go snog. Well, I don't see why they have to go off all the time. We were having fun. Evans ruined it.
Hey, Lily isn't so bad. She's smart, sweet, and she didn't care that I was a werewolf.
Just because doesn't mean the rest of us have to be in love with her.
What? I do not have a crush on Lily.
Whatever you say. You know what? We can have fun without them. I snuck this from the three broomsticks for all of us, but I guess they're going to miss out.
Fire whiskey? You're gonna get us in trouble. As a prefect.
As a prefect, you should pull that stick out of your arse and have a drink. You call that a drink?
That was a drink.
Maybe if you were a house elf, this is a drink.
What? Like this?
Much better. See, we can have fun without Potter and Evans.
We're sitting on a dusty floor getting drunk, Sirius. This isn't fun.
Only because you haven't had enough fire whiskey yet. You finish the bottle, I've got more.
The two friends continued to drink until they were both quite sloshed.
Hey, lavender all the pretty lights.
I'm too drunk to do this spell.
Let me try.
You're holding your wand backwards.
Maybe I'm drunk.
You were right, you know.
About what?
I have a crush on Lily.
Ha! I knew it! You should ask her out.
How drunk are you? She's with James.
That won't last forever. They don't belong together.
Why do you dislike Lily so much?
I don't dislike Evans.
Then what is it?
I like James.
Of course you do. He's our best friend. Lily isn't bad for him, though. I don't see why you can't...
No! Remus, I like James. I want to be with him.
Oh.
Almost told him. Got halfway there, and he blurted out that he just asked out Evans, and she said yes. He looked so happy, I couldn't say anything.
We're quite the pair, aren't we? Sitting in here, pining, while the objects of our affections are happily on a date with each other.
Hey, we're not pining, we're drinking.
We're having a pity party. Guess I should face up that I'm destined to be alone.
You don't have to be.
That's a nice thought, Sirius. But I can't expect every girl to be as understanding as Lily.
What if it's not a girl?
You're drunk, Sirius.
I am. And tomorrow, if you want, we can pretend this was all a drunken mistake. But for now... Still think I'm drunk?
Yes. And I think I'm drunk too.
Go.
Here to fight. I may not like you, Malfoy. That doesn't mean I want you dead. What's happening?
None of your business, Potter. Now saw it off.
I've been watching you.
So now you're stalking me. Get out!
Voldemort is back. You're helping him with something. Tell me.
He wants me to kill Dumbledore and bring Death Eaters into the castle. There, Potter. Now you know. You want to rethink cursing me now?
You can't. You can't do that.
I will. I've almost got it all figured out. What I can't do is let you ruin it. Oblivion.
We could protect you.
What?
If you go tell Dumbledore, we could protect you.
And what about my mother back at the manor, or my father in Azkaban? Some of us still have living parents, Potter.
Dumbledore will know what to do.
Why would you help me?
Because you may be a public skit, Malfoy, but you shouldn't have to suffer for your father's mistakes.
Potter. Wait, you want me to do what?
Yes. Hold on, I did not sign up for this.
What's going on? You want them to what? That is wrong. The scene is over.
Nope, Ginny, you are not in the scene. Continue and stick to the script.
I'm not kissing Potter.
Wait. What's the matter, Malfoy? Are you scared or something?
I am not scared.
Well, you look scared to me. Don't worry, you can always just walk off the stage, remember? Not everyone's up to all the pressure.
I can perform better than you, Weasel.
Then prove it. You call that a kiss? Even that Jacob guy kissed better than you.
Whoa.
That was perfect. Keep going.
Sorry, I don't know why I did that. All those things you said about protecting me. Never mind, it was obviously a mistake.
No, it wasn't.
He's doing a wonderful job of following my script, and if you don't stop interrupting, I'm gonna have to ask you to leave. Understand?
Now, we need to figure out a plan to deal with Voldemort.
I was working on fixing the vanishing cabinets to get the Death Eaters into the castle. Maybe we could do something about that? But what's gonna happen to my mother if I betray the Dark Lord?
It's okay. We'll figure something out.
How can you be so sure?
Because in the end, I have to face him. Because one of us has to die at the hands of the other. Neither can live the ocean lines.
What's that?
Prophecy.
Wait, you knew at 16 that you would have to face him alone?
I knew at 15. But I didn't know until the final battle that in order to defeat him, I would have to die.
And you did it anyway?
How could I not? It was the only way to save the people I love.
I wonder what would have happened if we'd ever talked.
How did that go? Probably nothing. You were and are a pompous git. But I shouldn't have used that curse on you. I swear, I didn't know what it would do.
I know you didn't. You should have seen your face. Harry Potter, savior of the wizarding world, realizing he might have just killed me. If I hadn't been dying, I might have laughed.
What are you doing?
Writing this down, it's getting really good.
But this isn't in the script?
No, the script ended when Draco asked Harry how he could be so sure. They should have left the bathroom, but this is golden.
Harry, what are you doing?
Nothing, we're just finishing the scene.
The scene ended a while ago. This is an outrage. We're leaving right now.
Oh, but it was just getting good. Okay, well, hold
on. What you do? First, you kiss Malfoy, and then, what are you doing?
We were just doing a scene, Jen. Hold on. Have you read this? I'm not doing this.
Oh, so you see Malfoy is fine, but a fake Professor Snape isn't?
Whoa, I'm with Harry. I don't care what it says in the script. This is too weird.
Well, I, for one, see nothing wrong with this scene. I'm ready to follow the script and show what a good actress I am.
Again. I almost forgot we need a narrator. Where's Allison? Allison! Jeffrey Schmidt. Okay, see where it says narrator?
Yeah.
Okay, those are the lines you're gonna read, okay?
Got it? to knock.
What?
You have to knock. Knock.
Enter.
Professor.
Hi, Miss Weasley. To what do I owe the pleasure?
I just had a question for you, Professor. Is that a wand in your pocket, or are you just happy to see me?
Slither in.
Oh my god. can see why your mother would end your dragon.
That was not a misread.
Wait, don't go.
When the next knock came, Snape was already prepared.
Enter. Miss Lovegood, what are you here to do?
Exactly what my name implies.
Something with the exact same dimensions.
I don't have time for your mindless riddles, Weasley. There's festivities to attend to.
Make a mistake and ask Ginny to marry me.
I'm sorry, make a bigger one and say yes.
Ron and Hermione, they're gonna break up. This is so wrong. Like, Harry should be with Ginny, not Draco. this is ruining everything.
It's not ruining anything. We are having a really great time. Right?
No.
See, look at Luna and Neville. They're having a great time.
No, this is all wrong.
making out with Snape.
And I don't want to forget what an insecure man you are.
They don't have to forget anything. This is what theater does. It opens eyes and minds. And you can't just make everyone forget all of that.
You have to forget.
We don't have to forget anything. You can't make us.
Actually, I can't.
Obliviate!
Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to this month's production of Fan Fiction Theater. Unfortunately, our cast didn't show up, and so this month's is canceled, but be sure to come back next month when the theme will be supernatural.